Time is running okay. Let's run a close chat now. Let's get started. I've always not I feel like I need to be marked. Okay. Gonna go with this. I'm not sure. Like he's obviously done some preparation, but I kind of want to feel out the game first match. Is this? I'm actually going to play c6 here. I think I'm going to first challenge him with the this. Okay. I'm going to go with this and see how he responds. I don't think he has preparation here. Okay, he goes for this. It's very. Okay, he goes for this, which definitely not complaining about. See what he does out there. Knight e5. Pretty sure I go like a4 here. And then g6, I think, is the move. Yeah, and I could be misremembering. I think the queen d1, g6 is the theory here. I'm completely fine with this position. I'm actually. This is what I want. I think g4 is the correct move. Yeah, it is. And then bishop g7. Should be six, I think. Or do I go back to c8? I go to e6. I think he goes f4 now. Again, I like that he's thinking here because I think we both don't know exactly what we're doing here. Well, I think we know what we're doing, but obviously, I am happy that he is not blitzing out the moves. Okay. So this is somewhat of a mistake. Let's go h5, obviously. Then I'm gonna go knight d7. See what he plays here. I think he made a mistake. Don't exactly remember what is fully correct there. So maybe he didn't make a mistake. Okay, bishop f5 makes a lot of sense. e5 is kind of right here, but plays f4. Somewhat expected. Oh, I kind of want to go h4 to prepare f6. So the goal of this position will be to break through with move f6. But obviously position remains quite double-edged. After f6 now, I think he just wasted a very key bishop d2, I feel like was a very crucial waste of time in terms of tempo because now I'm going straight sort of breaking things open. Okay, I'm definitely taking this. And then e5 looks good there, I guess. Takes. Can I go e5 immediately is another question. So e5 takes, push there, takes. Seems completely fine. Even takes, takes, takes. That also looks fine. Let's see. Pretty crucial moment. Interesting. Just feel like starting with bishop g7 is correct. It's like just building it up. With one move. Okay, now okay. Okay, we have seven, but taking too much time here. Honestly, why don't I just castle? takes in e5 is the big threat. Okay, e5 immediately here should just be very good. Right? Yeah. Because takes, I have e4. And then, yeah, that should be good. Okay, knight b4. That makes zero sense. Obviously takes. Okay, I can take this pawn, but seems like it's a little bit of a bait, but I feel like I just want to take the bait. Yeah, let's screw it. Screw it. This is very ambitious of me, considering bishop d3 is a possibility, many other quite dangerous moves, but takes knight e5. Honestly, I honestly I'm just gonna call his bluff. I think it's I'm just gonna call his bluff and see what happens. Could lose in a few moves or could have a pretty good position. But I think that this is And I'm putting a lot of faith into my intuition here. I'm putting quite a lot of faith into my intuition, but that is what I believe most in. I believe in my intuition quite a lot, so I'll let my intuition guide me here. When has my intuition let me down? Okay. Maybe this is the time it's let me down. But this is getting right here. Come on, Hans, this is your position. Shoot. Yeah, I played that. Oh my God, if Queen takes G6. Oh my God. Oh my God. Very bad. Very bad. That should never happen, Hans. Should never happen. So, okay. Sorry? No, I'll talk. When I've won my game, I'll speak. Fucking go! Outplayed. Win this cleanly. Cleanly. Yeah, just keep it so. Capelson. Wait, that's not good. I don't like what I'm doing. This is fun. Shit. Can I choke this? Oh my God. How did I do that? I'm so bad. Actually, so bad. I just choking everything on. Come on. Not like that, dude. Come on. It's not you. Very. Here's the thing with Ron's. He willingly repeats openings. Even when he gets bad positions. He's a man of habits. So I don't mind repeating the exact. Okay, he plays the correct move now. It's unfortunate. Very bad, very bad. Okay. Whatever, just forget about it. Just forget about it. Move on. You're playing better chess. Playing better chess, that's all I need to do. Just play better chess. Okay. You're the better player. You're playing better moves. You just got to close them out. No reason for those games not to be won. What is this move again? We're transposing. But. Well, we're not even transposing. It's. We're getting somewhat of a similar version, but I was definitely happy with the position I got before, despite the result of the game. Bishop d3 is annoying, though. Takes push. Could be some sack. Okay. Play H3. Could be very wrong, but I believe in the idea. Queen F3, that was expected. But thought I had, but isn't that a mistake? Okay, I think I've calculated correctly here. If takes takes queen g3, right, bishop f6, rook f5, gf, and then bishop h4 at the end. So okay, I'm going for probably the most complicated line, but again, I in those past two games, right? I should be winning them 100% of the time. Okay, so I think he fell for another one of my tricks. I'm gonna go check now. I'm a tricky guy. Okay, now what's wrong with e4? Knight e4. Okay. But even that, can I take? Then knight d5. Yes, I'll take. I can go for this. And then I have to somehow prove that I'm fine here. Start with queen g4. I'm probably going to end up sacrificing a piece for a few pawns at some point. But again, I feel like I can take my time, but whenever I've been taking my time, I've been choking. So like, if I'm going to take my time, I can't choke. That's pretty self-explanatory, but I'm getting into these scrambles where I believe I'm objectively a better player and I should be winning them, but I'm too low on time, which is impeding that. Okay, I'll take. I think this sacrifice is just good. I'm up a pawn. I have this advanced H pawn. His minor pieces are just bad. I feel like he's going to have to go for some sort of counter sacrifice here. I want to trade the queens. Now I'm going to go knight d7, target the c5 pawn. I'm going to have some rook g8, rook g2 ideas. I think I have definitely won this encounter. C5 lost, and okay. Knight's gonna come to e4 next. Okay, knight g4. Get this rook f3. I'll go knight e4 first. Again, if I can make a trade on e4, then this bishop on e1 strap. Yeah, this is gonna be a game. Like, this is what I need to do, and everything can be simple. Okay, it takes taking, is giving up that pawn indirectly, so I'll take this way. And then two options, kind of like c4, to be honest. But I want to maintain pressure here. Oh, he allows this. I don't know why I thought I could play that. C5, rook f6. No. This was a bit of a mistake. I'll just play this. Okay, I'll just go c5, screw it. Oh, wait, rook in? Definitely should be winning here. But again, it's a matter of technique. Technique I don't seem to possess today. Okay. I shouldn't be winning this 100% of the time. My win rate here should be 100%. And if it's not, then just a bad chess player. Okay. I have to go here. I have to find a good way to sneak around. Okay, I'll make a waiting move. Wow. Should I have here? Holy shit. And I did it. I found a way to lose it. You've got to be kidding me. What is up with me today? Finding ways to lose the, like, and then somehow swindling. Just a very easy draw. My technique today is absolutely trash. It's okay though. Only 2-1. Not playing him, he's just defending like a beast. Extremely impressive. Going on here. What line is he going play? Goes for this. A takes. Believe is incorrect, but I think the simplest way is to take back. Makes the most sense. G4 is even tempting. To be honest, it's pretty tempting. But why not? Play this move in 3-0, so why not in 3-2? He's not going to go for that sack, right? Yeah, he's not going to. Not even going to let him. Queen b6 is just a bad move. This is a very good position. The lights go out. For some reason, I thought he couldn't castle queenside. I don't know why. Now he's going to face some issues. My light square bishop is going to be very strong pretty soon. Magic. There's a certain feeling you get when you're feeling your shit. They're feeling your shit. This is your moment. Again, I could even win a pawn directly, right? Over just meant what's in it's in. Shit think it's in. And it is Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie. Awesome thing. I don't know. I could go direct, but I could go Queen H5, but then E5 is the question. And I can win a pawn. But it's should I don't think I should be scared. Queen H5, E5, take, check. There it takes. King over. Queen F5. It takes, Queen F5. Yeah. I'm not going to be afraid of a ghost. Maybe it's not a ghost. My bone pillow. Same idea, right? Yeah, that works, I guess, right? Yeah, Queen H5, G6, Queen H7, E5, take, Bishop H3, King B8, Queen F7, Bishop D6, Queen D5, if King E8, take, Queen E6, Bishop D6, Queen D5, and if Queen A6, Bishop F1, and I think I shut everything down. I'm taking quite a materialistic approach. Okay. He goes into it, but I don't think he calculated it at all. Yeah, he's realizing now his miscalculations, I think. But check now. Obviously, there's gonna be knight d3, but I don't think I should be afraid of these types of positions. I've played the entire match going for very I just need to trust my instinct. It's been working. You know, it's King A8, I play takes, Queen E6, and I don't see the solution. Knight D3, I can just go King F1, Queen B5, and King G1 there. Okay, takes and Queen E6, I think is the best. Yeah. So this is where my calculation ended, and I think just up a pawn. And I don't see where the evident compensation is. So I should win the game. Okay, this is also something I looked at, but I think this is, I was hoping he would be optimistic and do this. But again, it could be me being the one that's optimistic, thinking I'm not going to get mated here. But still, I don't see it. I think it's a huge bluff, to be honest. I think it's just a huge bluff. And I've said that about like a lot of his positions that I think he's just bluffing. And I've been consistently right. King F1, King E2. Kingy 2 actually might be the best. Probably shouldn't spend time nitpicking, but I think Kingy 2 is the best move. Oh, there's knight takes f2. Yeah, so Kingy 2 is obviously the best. Oh, there's knight takes f2. Shoot. Yeah, knight takes f2 is quite the move. Can I go queen e6? Still doesn't work. This move is extremely risky. And I did it with no time on the clock. Oh my God, that was such shit decision making. That was some really bad decision making. I survive this. I think I deserve to survive this, to be honest. Like, after the shit that I've thrown, I think I deserve to survive this. Like, I survived this. Hope. Okay, shut the fuck up, on to focus. Wait, honestly, it must be winning. There's no way it's not winning. Got him! Good technique, Hans. Good shit! Good shit, Hans! Good job, good job, good job. Okay. That karma has been restored, okay? This match has been a shit show, but that is karma, okay? That is just like the level of play in this match has been really bad. Like I've thrown two wins, no three, like two wins. He had a, you know, it's the world is even. You know, since I'm on the Chess24 channel, so obviously, you know, I can't break a mouse. But if I was on my channel, I'd definitely be, you know, there might be a few slams. Okay, he goes g3. It's going for the, you know, what's your positional routes? But it's, okay, he goes queen d6, so he's not surprised that he's going for this. But again, I want a close position. I believe in myself to play well in close positions, so give me a close position and I believe I'll do my thing, but again, I'm not going to trade the queens. I want to keep as many pieces on the board as possible. Okay, very simple. That was a mistake. You should have moved the rook f to c1. I assume he's going to go queen back. Yeah, we do. So he's not wasting any time. Could go b6. But it's a bit impulsive. Maybe it's a bit premature. I could go knight h5 and then b6. But. How about, well, could even rush bishop d8 and delay castling. This is an interesting idea. That's a mistake. Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie. Nas and Femi. Lot of envy. Lot of Femi. Another envy. Problem with me. Oh, what? Blunders. Did the lights go out? Did they give out? Can't check my mouth. I'ma rip the shit till my bone fall out. The lights go out, I'ma make it out. Can't shut my mouth. Okay. I can feel his tilt. I can feel his tilt. That's a new song. Every word. Oh my God. It's like my mouth is drooling. I can just taste. It's like I can taste the tilt. I have a pro tip for chess players watching. If you want to play your best chess, don't eat. Okay? You will play your best chess on an empty stomach because you will crave the win, literally and figuratively. Pro tip, don't eat before a chess game. Okay, takes an a5 is. So make sure to take a little note, guys. I fasted before this chess game. For this chess match. I'm only on drinking water because my body, as soon as you eat, like when you're not eating, your primitive instincts and adrenaline are going because you're trying to hunt. So your senses are like inflated. So like you only want to drink water because the hydration, to go to the mitochondria and to do the thing that gives you energy, like that's what you want. Like you need water for, what's that shit called that gives you energy in the mitochondria? Whatever, dude. No one cares. No one cares. But anyways, don't eat if you're playing a chess here as much. Also, I'm not saying that, you should starve yourself, but I do have, I do like genuinely believe that eating and playing on an empty stomach significantly increases play. And take that from an I am like, oh, I'm just an international master. So why would you listen to me? True. Everyone in China is like Pago who asked, but the thing is that I can taste. I can. I'm tasting him right now, and he tastes like juicy tilt. Okay, he's just blundered. Oh, he played that. I didn't see that coming. I would say oops, but that would ruin my entire little ramble. All planned, don't worry, All planned. Okay, I actually need to shut up. Slur does not give a fuck. Okay, this is a time to really take your time. It's not a time to make a rash decision. Okay. Yeah, I've noticed this bug where the time like goes down and then like it says it flags, but it doesn't actually flag. It's quite a weird bug. Like there's this bug on the play zone where it goes to point two, but then hops back up. It's very weird. But like it says, like there's. Okay, 3-2, let's go. See if he wants to repeat. Actually, knight to 2 is correct here. Okay, he fell for the trick, I think. have looked at this. I think he fell for it. But isn't this just like winning? It's a free pawn, right? I love Andrew Tang so much. Andrew, I love you so much. Andrew prepped me here. Guys, Andrew is literally like, me and Andrew analyze this exact position. I honestly would not have won this match without Andrew's help, because he told me the opening to play and everything. So, and I will maybe I'll get Andrew a present or something. But the openings I've played in this match or with white have all been Andrew's prep, and they've been, well, not okay, the opening with black that I've been playing has been my own personal prep. But definitely can't complain with how the opening's going. So if Andrew, you're watching, I will be you'll get some sort of present or something. I don't know what it'll be, but I'll get you something. Because like the positions I've gotten with white, like I've analyzed like both of them. So, okay, he has knight h5. I probably should play h3 at some point. If he doesn't play knight h5, he's definitely on tilt. I expect him to play knight h5. If he doesn't play knight h5, something's definitely, oh, he disconnected. Oh, he disconnected, oh. Wait, hello? He disconnected, hello? Oh boy, oh boy. Oh no, oh no. This is, wait, what are the disconnection rules? Like, oh no. Kobe on such a nice guy, but like, this is a serious match. I might have to be a jerk, but, not even being a jerk, but, oh boy. The thing is that if I disconnect in this position, it's really unfortunate for me because I have a very good position. So to disconnect here would be very unfortunate because I would be inclined, since this is a very serious match. Okay, he's back, thankfully. That's good. Okay, he's back. Good. I didn't want to have to do that. So thankfully we avoided that situation. But to be honest, I don't know what I would do there because it's a lot at stake and he's a nice guy and all, but I want to win, so kind of have to put your friendships or opinions by people aside. But it's okay. I don't want to win that way, but I'll take a win anyway it comes. Since there's so much on the line here. Okay, queen b3. I'm gonna trade queens. I'm gonna trade queens on my terms. I don't wanna trade and open up the a file. Hopefully, you can just save. Okay. Yeah, that bishop is really annoying. That bishop is a huge pain. I'll take and go knight b1, actually. I'm going to really consolidate here and Okay, does he have that? Okay, there's okay, A3. It should be two. Is it blunder? Is it actually a blunder? Let's see what's wrong with knight c3. If I get my knight to b5, I'm chilling. It takes. Oh, shoot. Shoot. Wait. No, it's fine, yeah? What is it? Should see one. Holding on here. No, I don't like how loose my position is. I don't like how loose it is at all. It's gonna go F6. It goes there. Could full send with D5. That's good. F4 now. Yeah, it's unfortunate that he lost some time there, but I don't think his extra time affected the result of the game, or his loss of time affected the result. No, it's not even that clear. Honestly, I'm just gonna go for this. Like, I'm not gonna take any risks here. Like, actually, you could go for a more direct path, but goes there. I don't. Bishop d2. Yeah, bishop d2 looks like the move here. And then takes, and then knight c4, and then this knight is trapped. Rook f3 ends it. Takes, and then takes. Okay, I'll take. 4-2. Let's go. Let's go over the same Slav. Ultra solid. I'm not going to take any risks. Actually, yeah, I could play my same chess, but I think there's no reason to take any unnecessary risks here. I feel very comfortable with the opening I've played, and I trust my play, so we've repeated this quite a few times. A4, G6. So, there's actually a position here where you can like go for an extremely drawish like set, like line of it. And I think I'm just gonna go. I've studied this a while ago. Back when I used to really study chess. This was a staple in my repertoire. I don't mind repeating this variation. I'm completely fine repeating the exact moves of the previous game. So I'm pleased with my position. So okay, plays f5 here, which is definitely incorrect. For some reason, I had a feeling he would play this move. I don't know why. I thought to myself, like a few seconds ago, I was like, oh, what if he plays this? But I'm gonna go h4. And I think he's overstepping here. I have a feeling he's definitely overstepping. My next moves, actually, I put arrows on. Bishop c8 now. And then I just go e6 and I close the position. I just close the position and then what does he have? He has knight h5, but still, also the bishop on d2 is c1 is a very bad piece. Okay, e6. My position is so solid. Threatening to take the pawn, but it's not that imminent of a threat. It gives me the pawn, but I think he's going a bit too far. But just in the spirit of the match score, I think it's unnecessary for me to even indulge such a position when I can play knight h7 and just have a good position. I have to pee. I might do a bathroom gambit, to be honest. Okay. F6. I actually don't like how I've opened up the position even a little bit. Like even opening up this much is making me uncomfortable. Oh, the root word. Thoughts are sporadic. Act like I'm an addict. Hit the smack like I'm Kim Mathers. But again, I'm not gonna play this position like scared or something. Because yeah, okay. I'm not gonna play this like I'm scared because I just have a great position. Till the lights go up, till my leg give out, can't check my mouth. Bring the rook over now. Gonna go e5 at some point. Going to time it. I also did bishop on d7. Okay, this knight takes a4, but highly that he plays it. Okay. So, Richie won. And what happens if I play e5? But there's no reason to even indulge myself. There's no reason to even like have an ounce of risk in the position. You know, I should not get greedy here. I'm gonna win the game, but I don't need to do it in some sort of fancy fashion that's poses risk in my end. D4. My king looks pretty open, but I have so many pieces around my king. Like all my pieces are so together. His coordination is pretty bad. And I'm gonna go knight e6 and move it into f4. Like there's the only piece holding it together. Bishop's gonna come to d5, h3, bishop d5. It's just a very dominating position here. I think the key part of this match was just the opening selection on mine. Wait. Okay. Maybe I'm it. What am I missing? Nothing. Yeah, I'm not missing anything. It's a pure bluff. This is kind of when you call it all in and they've got, Deuce 7. Okay. What's the simplest way? How do I shut this down as quickly as possible? Trading queens seems like a good first step. With the queens off, I'm feeling very comfortable. Even though I shouldn't be abiding to such basic rules, I feel quite comfortable with the queens off the board because I know me, and I know that throughout this match, the positions I've messed up have been far from. Yeah, anyways. Don't think I can lose this position. I think I'm gonna have to try really hard to lose this position. Like, it's gonna take some serious effort on my end. It's gonna take some serious efforts. It's the match. Good match. Obviously, huge respect to Mr. Malkumian. He played a great match. Really made me fight for it. Always a pleasure playing him. But we got it. So I guess I'll be on to the next one. I'm playing the world champion, the world blitz champion next match. So obviously, it's going to be super tough. But I'm very happy with my play. So, you know, it is huge respect to him.